Let's discuss thermodynamic parameters of a gaseous process. As in the previous section we have studied, there are three thermodynamic parameters which are used in defining first law of thermodynamics. So we can write, for a thermodynamic process, there are three thermodynamic parameters associated with the process. These are, our first one is heat supply. Second one is change in internal energy. And the third one is work done by the gas. Now we are going to discuss all these three step by step in detail. For a complete process, heat supplied is denoted by the letter Q. Change in internal energy is denoted by delta U. Work done is denoted by the letter W. So let's discuss the three parameters in detail, how we are going to use these mathematically in a process. Now we'll see how to calculate the heat supplied to a gaseous system. And we'll also define the specific heats of a gas. When we talk for liquids, all of you know that for liquids, when we discuss about the specific heat, it is denoted by S. And if for a given substance, a specific heat is known, it is also valid not only for liquids and solids also. If a specific heat is given, we can easily calculate the amount of heat supplied to raise the temperature of a given substance, which can be given as Q is equals to Ms delta T, which was the basis of the section of calorimetry. Here S was measured in joule per kilogram degree centigrade and temperature is measured in centigrade, masses in kilogram. So this will give us the amount of heat in joule. Similarly, for gram specific heat, it can be measured as calorie per gram degree centigrade. In that case, mass will be taken in grams, and similar calculations can be done here. But when we talk about gases, so we can say for gases, the very first thing is specific heat, which is defined as per kilogram or per gram. This S is known as gram specific heat or kilogram specific heat. For gases, we define molar specific heat. Molar specific heat is basically the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a gas by unity. This is denoted by C. And in this situation, we can see the amount of heat supplied for n moles of gas for temperature rise delta T. This can be easily given as Q is equal to nc delta T, because here C is the molar specific heat, which is measured in joule per mole Kelvin or degree centigrade. So that n are number of moles, k delta T is in Kelvin. This will give us the amount of heat to raise the temperature of n moles of gaseous system by delta T, if C is the molar specific heat of the system. But you need to be very careful in this situation. Like for solids and liquids, the specific heat is a constant for a given range of temperature. But in case of gases, C need not be a constant. It may be a function of pressure, volume or temperature. So we can say, for a variable value of C, we can use the total heat supplied as integration of Nc dT for temperature variation from T1 to T2. Now, here you need to be very careful that this expression is used whenever C is a variable. And there are many cases in which for a gas the value of C changes with the either of temperature, pressure or volume. Let's continue it. Here we can see that as for solids and liquids, for a given range we consider S as a constant. But we can see for gases, molar specific heat depends on the way of supplying heat to the system. That means if we change the way to supply heat, its specific heat will change, and even for the given situation, the molar specific heat will change. So we can state in the situation of thermodynamic processes, in different processes, for a single gas, C will change. For a given gas, if we change the process of heating or process of supplying heat to the gaseous system, its molar specific heat will change. This is also termed as molar heat capacity. This is going to change. Now, we'll study change in internal energy of a gas. And as we already studied, we can write, as we know, internal energy of a gas can be written as F by 2 nRT, where F are the degrees of freedom, N are the number of moles of gas, R gas constant, T is the absolute temperature. Here we can directly state, if temperature of the gas increases by dT, the increase in internal energy can be given as, here it can be written as U is directly proportional to temperature as all other factors are constant. So you can simply write dU, which is the increase in internal energy, is F by 2 nR is a constant, it will be dT. So this dU equals to F by 2 nR dT is the increase in internal energy for temperature rise dT. We can state if temperature of gas increases from T1 to T2. If it is increasing from T1 to T2, then total change in internal energy for this process can be directly written as delta U is integration of dU, which is integration of F by 2 nR dT, which is integrated from T1 to T2. Here F by 2 nR is a constant, so here delta U can be written as F by 2 nR T2 minus T1. This is the relation which we use for change in internal energy in all type of processes. So be careful, this is used for all kind of thermodynamic processes. Various specified kinds of thermodynamic process we are going to discuss in upcoming articles. But you must keep in mind, as we have discussed in case of heat supply, as process changes, the specific heat will change and hence the supplied heat will also change for a given rise in temperature. But it is not the case in case of increase in internal energy. It is always same for all kind of processes. Now, the last thermodynamic parameter is work done by a gas. As we have discussed in the previous section, whenever a gas expands, it does work against the atmospheric pressure, because atmospheric pressure is opposing, and as the gas pressure is more than atmospheric pressure, it will expand. So, mechanical work will be done by the gas on atmosphere. To analyze and understand the calculation of work done, let's consider an illustration. Say we are having a cylindrical container like this, which I'm drawing here. And say it is closed by a movable piston. And a gas is trapped between the piston and the cylinder. This is called a piston cylinder system. In this situation, atmosphere will be exerting a pressure P atmosphere on it. And if I consider this piston to be lightweight, obviously in this situation, gas pressure P is equal to atmospheric pressure because the piston we can see here is in equilibrium. Now in this situation, if I just put a burner beneath the cylinder and we supply a heat to it, say dQ amount of heat is supplied by heating the cylinder. Then if gas is heated up, its temperature will increase, correspondingly its pressure will increase. If its pressure will increase, it will push the piston in upward direction and the piston will move up. As it will move up, the volume of gas will increase and pressure will drop back to the atmospheric level. Because the piston is lightweight, so always gas pressure has to be maintained at atmospheric pressure. So we can state on heating, the piston will move up by a distance dx and say this is a new position of this piston. On this situation, if its cross-sectional area is taken as S, we can state here volume increment of gas. It can be written as dV, which is equal to S dx if S is the area and dx is the displacement in the piston. Now in this situation, as the piston is pushed by the pressure of gas, we can say work done by gas in this process is, in this elemental process is dW, which can be written as Ps into dx. Ps is the force exerted by gas onto this piston, P is the pressure, S is its area, multiplied by dx, which is the displacement of piston. Now in this situation, if this S dx can be written as dV, so it will become dW is equals to pdV. This is the work done by the gas on surrounding. So we can state whenever gas expands, it is doing work on surrounding. And whenever gas is being compressed by the atmospheric pressure or any other external pressure, we can say the work done will be negative because we'll write it minus Ps dx. And here we can say if volume of gas increases from V1 to V2, then here we use work done as integration of dW, which can be written as integration of pdV from V1 to V2. This expression you should always keep in mind. Whenever we are required to find the work done by a gas, we are going to use it, which is quite an important relation. And always remember here, if volume is increasing, if gas expands, work done by gas is taken positive, and if gas is compressed, work done is taken negative, because when it is compressed, work is done by external agent or atmosphere on the gaseous system. So work done by a gas we are studying, that will always be taken as negative in case of compression, and in case of expansion, it is always taken positive.